Trying to do this, I play in this space. So the beat is so it's more like on the off beat. Like how we have like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, bam, 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 bam. So is I try to sing the part before I play. So when the song is playing, I listen to it and try to find a space and try to find a rhythm that will go inside the space. That's what I do first. Right? So that's why I found the bam bam. The up strum have a lot to do with it as well. So this song is in B, so it's the 4 chord, which is E, then 1, then 6, then 5. So it's like so that's where the up strum is. So it's a tight strum, so every time I strum, I squeeze down on the string and I release back, so it's sound kind of tight. So and sometimes I let these strings vibrate a little longer, so it gives it a nice kind of swing, like I kind of learn a lot from playing jamu with the black man, so that kind of helped me out a lot. So that's where I kind of find that swing on the upbeat, right? So that's on the rhythmic side. On the chord side, if you notice, I'm not using full bar chords. I'm just playing, this is like the A shape. If it's like the cage system, it's like the A shape of the E chord. So, and then, so if I play from first finger here, I play in the E chord, I could go to the one chord down here. So this is the B chord here, which is the D shape. Right, and then the sixth chord is right here. And the five chord right here. Again, so it's the four. Right? And one. Six right here. And then the five right here. So there's a lot of the cage system shapes I like to use. And I try to make it kind of close. So I could play the 4 chord right here, 1, 6, 5, again the upstroke, right? is on the one, it's on the first beat of the bar. So it'll be like, so it's like one, two, three, let me get the beat here. So, right. So that's how I have it. I have it on the. So yeah, I try to kind of find myself in a little space. And not play too much of strumming, like a you know, like
one thing
I used to do a lot was like a split as the strumming, but it you know, it doing the song fun. I don't want to play too much. That's too much, right? So, again, I just try to find the rhythm, pop pop dum, pop pop, right? So I think singing have a lot to do with it, and trying to find that space and not trying to overplay it, and right hand technique have a lot to do with it, and so much other things, how we hold the pick. I use a very pointy tip pick, and I use just the side of the pick, so I don't strum flat on the string, you know, kind of tilt the pick slightly down and a little bit of wrist, so I get this side of the pick cutting through the strings and then the back coming back up, so it's a straight down and a straight up, right? So this have a lot to do with it here too, the rhythm, right? And rhythm is the key. I have a lot of drumming background from African drums, folk drums, best version. That kind of helps us a little bit. So rhythm is the key for this, right? I hope that this video was very helpful, right? So Brian, you could I hope you learned some stuff from it. And anybody else, feel free to check it out. And yeah, all the best. Yeah.